So, Season of the Lost came out on Tuesday, and with the whole showcase of Witch Queen, as well as my first impressions coming next week, I wanted to get a video out, and what better video to do than covering the new seasonal weapon, because that's fun, and also how you can get the catalyst associated with it later, quick and easy, because that's a bit of a grind. So, let's get started. The Lawrence Driver is the new exotic linear fusion rifle, and it's pretty broken. Consider it Arbalest 2.0 with wall hacks. Exotic perk, Longrian Sight. Lagrangian Sight. This weapon marks targets with an automated targeting system, aka wall hacks. Final blows on marked targets generate a telemetry pattern. When picking up these patterns, you will get bonus ability energy, and collecting 3 in a row without dying will increase the damage for 20 seconds. And this buff will maintain itself even when switching weapons. So, it's a pretty weird perk, but it's also pretty simple. It's just an absolute mouthful. Occasionally, the gun will pick a special target that it will hone in on with some wall hack abilities, and when you kill that target, they will drop a tiny little talisman. Picking up that talisman will give you a pretty substantial chunk of ability energy, working the same way that Wellspring does, and you can also collect 3 for 20 seconds of extra damage, like I said earlier. Now getting on to the second perk itself, M Anomaly. A precision final blow with this weapon creates an implosion that pulls in nearby targets. It's pretty good in PvE. It's a pretty good balance between PvE and PvP utility, with a pretty decent amount of ad clear with the explosion and the kind of graviton lance kind of thing, where it pulls in enemies and makes them explode. It's pretty great. In PvP, it's basically become the new meta because the wall hack ability still occurs while the weapon is stowed. So occasionally, you can just engage in 1v1s with complete knowledge of where the enemy is going to be, making this basically essential if you want to do anything really competitive. And so people are just putting this in their loadouts, and it's considered the new meta, and the gun isn't really getting used much at all. When it is getting used, it's completely based on your aim. Linear fusion rifles have been pretty wonky since they were nerfed all the way back in, I think, Season of the Drifter. But yeah, they've been pretty jank. So if you can hit your headshots, good. If you can only hit body shots, too bad. Now, moving on to the whole Catalyst questline. You are going to have to do quite a bit, but not a lot. So specifically for the week that this video is up, which is the week of the season launching, we have Momentum Control as part of the Crucible rotation. And that's basically the prime time you want to do anything like this. And because it's momentum control, this weapon absolutely dominates. You have instant wall hacks, one hit body shots, the whole lot. It's great. So basically the whole thing with this is you need to generate data by completing playlist activities, killing guardians and other enemies in PvE within strikes. So I recommend momentum control for those guardian defeats. In total, you're gonna have to kill around 100, but when it's one shot body shotting, it shouldn't be too bad. You could probably get it done within an hour or two, depending on how good you are at Crucible. And mostly you just want to do things like the Nightfall for calibration data, especially if you have a dedicated team that can complete it quickly. My team was able to complete it within like 11 minutes when it's the Fanatic. So if you can complete Nightfalls regularly and within a low time frame, it's very, very good for you completing that objective quickly. And then you can just, if you don't have the kills that you need on PvE stuff, just load it into a playlist strike. It's pretty great.
But Zexy, what does the Catalyst even do?
I bet you're asking right now, totally real and not made up, viewer. Well, the Catalyst itself does actually a pretty good job of complementing the weapon itself. When you have the 3 telemetry patterns, each kill will detonate the anomaly. So you don't need a precision hit no more. You simply need to kill an enemy and they will completely explode, making ad clear an absolute breeze. And you will have enhanced radar, which means while this is stowed away, you can just have literal aimbot. Well, not aimbot, more like wall hacks. You might as well have this on when you're playing Crucible constantly. Why they would make a weapon that lets you have wall hacks for the entire match, I don't know, man, I don't know. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Beware of this weapon in Trials, because you're going to have a lot of fun with it. Feel free to leave a like or dislike if you feel so inclined to do so. And make sure to hit the subscribe button down below if you want to keep up to the date with whatever content I decide to make, whether it be reviews, guides, dumb stuff, I don't know. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, and that'll be all for me. Have a wonderful rest of your day.